An acquired brain injury is anything that happens post-birth or after birth that causes damage or trauma to the brain.
They can be internal or external causes, external being a fall or a car accident or something of that nature where there's a trauma to the head, or it can be more of an internal process like a brain tumor, aneurysm, or things like that. Anything that happens inside a person's brain, a stroke is another example of an acquired brain injury. Psychologists and physicians rank head injuries and they call them mild, moderate, or severe head injuries. So there's quite a range, but it's not to be confused that a mild brain injury is in any way inconsequential. A traumatic brain injury is a subcategory of acquired brain injuries. What a traumatic brain injury means is there's some external force exerted on the head, like hitting your head on something or having something strike your head that causes damage to the brain. So it's traumatic in nature. Some common means by which individuals suffer a traumatic brain injury could be a motor vehicle crash, a fall, sport-related concussions, or other kinds of blunt force trauma to their head are very common causes of concussion all the way up to severe brain injuries. Non-traumatic acquired brain injuries are things like brain tumors, strokes, aneurysms, anoxic brain injuries where the brain is without oxygen for a period of time, drug-induced brain injuries where there's some internal process rather than some blunt force trauma to the head. The signs and symptoms of a brain injury are very widespread. There are generally three classes of symptoms or signs that an individual has following a brain injury. In terms of cognitive symptoms or thinking types of problems, an individual will often have short-term memory deficits where they can't form new memories efficiently. Concentration and attention is another common set of symptoms related to brain injury. And the general speed of a person's thinking is slowed down after a brain injury because the brain is operating at less than 100% efficiency while it's trying to recover from the injury. Physical symptoms can include things like headache, nausea, dizziness. You can see things like vomiting. There may be discharge from the ears or nose. That would be on the more severe level of a brain injury. And then also the third class is really emotional types of symptoms. So there could be a lot of emotional dysregulation, depression, anxiety, fear, or the lack of those things that occurs following a brain injury. The onset of symptoms can occur immediately, and often they do. But again, they can occur several days to several weeks later. The best example of that are frontal lobes, which develop throughout life and they're really not fully operational until an individual is between 18 and 21 years old. So a young child, for example, can have a frontal lobe injury that is practically invisible until those functions are developmentally expected to be online. So then the person becomes 16, 17 years old, and all of a sudden problems start popping up in school or in social situations. Well, it's a result of that injury that occurred 10 or 15 years ago, but you really don't see the symptoms until developmentally you expect to see those functions present.
When I think about this, I think about the number of times I've seen something like America's Funniest Home Videos, and you laugh when you see someone fall and hit their head on something, but is that person all right? You know, I mean, that could be brain injury right there. People don't even think of it like that. Let's just take a look at the stats. You know, every year, 2.2 million people sustain a traumatic brain injury. That equates roughly to about one person every 15 seconds. That's more than the total number combined of people with breast cancer, HIV, AIDS, lung cancer, ALS, Alzheimer's, and even prostate cancer.
The Office of Acquired Brain Injury is there to help provide the best quality of life for someone who has a brain injury. We're there to help them find the resources they need, guide them to educate and raise awareness. Brain injury can bring on really scary and nerve-wracking and anxious times in your life, but there's hope and there's a way to get through it and there is going to be a good life to follow. And a lot of times it's just needing to know what resources are out there. If you need help navigating the maze, the Office of Acquired Brain Injury is here to help.